Welcome back to Gate Baba. In this lecture, I am going to teach you the importance of Heisler charts in unsteady state connection. In before lecture, I taught you about the lumped heat analysis. Where we use the lumped heat analysis? Where there is a small, very small thermal conduction resistance. That means the internal conduction resistance is very small when compared to the external convective resistance. In that case, we use the lumped heat analysis system. So, in that system, the temperature distribution is given by T minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity equals exponential of e power minus HA by rho VC multiplied by time. Okay, so it is the expression for temperature distribution when the Biot number is less than 0.1. Okay, what is Biot number? I told you it is the ratio of internal conductive resistance to the external convective resistance. Here the C means conductive, here the C means convective. If it is less than 0.1, then we use the temperature distribution like this. Okay. If it is greater than 0.1, we don't know how to solve the problem, and that is given by the Heisler. If Biot number lies between 0.1 and 100, okay, if Biot number lies between 0.1 and 100, that means for greater than 0.1 and within 100, what is the procedure to solve the problem? What is the procedure to find the temperature at a given point? That means it is no longer a case of very minute internal conductive resistance. It is a case involving the temperature gradients within the solid. Okay. Up to now we deal with the systems where the temperature gradients are very small, so that we can neglect that. But here we can't neglect the temperature gradients. Here in this case, that the temperature is a function of space coordinates as well as time. That means the temperature gradients are not negligible here. We have to consider these things also. And for those things, this expression can be written as, in respect of these things, T minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity equals e power of minus Biot number multiplied by Fourier number. Okay, it is our second non-dimensional number in the heat transfer up to now, and the other name of this Fourier number is non-dimensional time. If you closely observe, okay, I didn't give in the formula. The formula for Fourier number is alpha T by LC square, where alpha is the thermal diffusivity, T is the time, and LC is the characteristic dimension. Okay, we know the formula for alpha. What is that? It is K by rho C. And what are the units for alpha? Meter square per second. Is that okay? So if you just substitute the units here, meter square per second, for T it is second, second will get cancelled. What is the units for LC square? It is meter square. So meter square will get cancelled again. So, Fourier number has no units, literally no units. If you closely observe this relation, minus Biot number multiplied by Fourier number, and that is equals this thing. There is no difference between this and this. You want to check it? Okay, I will check for you here. Biot number multiplied by Fourier number. Okay, what is the Biot number? HLC by K. Okay, here K means K of solid multiplied by alpha T by LC square. Okay, here LC is a suffix number, LC square. Okay, LC will get cancelled for one time, then it will become H alpha T by K LC. Okay, where alpha is nothing but K by rho C. So H K divided by rho c this KLC. Okay, KK will get cancelled and you will get H by rho c LC. We know that LC is given by volume by surface area. Okay, if you just substitute that in the above equation, and that will give HA by rho VC. I forgot to write T time. Okay, HAT by rho VC. The same expression, HAT by rho VC. Okay, are you convinced now? Here we have not done anything new. We just changed the names of this equation. We have written these terms in terms of Biot number and Fourier number, so that for each and every value of Biot number and for each and every value of Fourier number, we have definite values of the temperature distribution. That means, if I take some values of Biot number, what can be the possible values of Biot number? I told you, I use this expression when the Biot number is greater than 0.1 and within 100. So the values of Biot number are 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, and so on, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, 99 and 100. Okay. And what are the possible values of Fourier number? We know the Fourier number is given by alpha t by LC square. At time equals 0, the Fourier number exists and that equals 0. So Fourier number starts from 0 and there is no end for the Fourier number. In Heisler charts, he just considered up to 700. Why? Because there is no practical problem more than 700. So in the Heisler charts, he just given up to 700 only. Okay. For each and every combination of Biot number and Fourier number, there is a specific value of temperature distribution. Okay. If I take the Biot number 0.1 and if I take a Fourier number of 10, and with this configuration, with this specification, the temperature distribution is T minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity equals e power minus Biot number multiplied by Fourier number. Is that okay? So that means e power, what is Biot number? 0.1. So minus 0.1 multiplied by Fourier number is 10. So it is the value you get the temperature distribution. So you can find the temperature at a given time. Here in this term, there is no temperature. You think like that? That is wrong. The Fourier number is itself related with time. So for time 1 second, the Fourier number will be different. For time 2 seconds, the Fourier number will be different. So the Fourier number integrates the time. So at a given time, you can find the temperature of a solid. Okay. If the Biot number is greater than 0.1. So for each and every value of Biot number and for each and every value of Fourier number, there are set of specific temperature distribution values. The total ratio they have found out and they plotted in a graph. And the graph is between the Fourier number and the temperature distribution. And what is the relation? There is also some special term Biot number. So you have to interpret that Biot number also. So the Biot number lines are like this in the Heisler chart. I told you the temperature, the Biot number starts from 0.1. So here it is very complicated to start the Biot number as it is. So they have taken inverse of Biot number. So that if the value is 1 by 0.1 and that will be 10. So the values will start from 10 and ends at some larger values. Sorry, some smaller values. Why? Because if I go 0.1 to 100, the inverse will be decreased. Okay, 1 by 100 means 0.01. So the value is 0.01, the last value of the chart. It may be like this, the shapes. Okay, if I want to find the Biot number at 0.3 and Fourier number at some 70, you just locate 1 by 0.3 line in these crossed lines. So 1 by 0.3 line may be this line or this line. I am just selecting this line randomly. Okay, so it is the 1 by 0.3 Biot number line. So the respected Fourier number from the given problem is 70. So the Fourier number 70 may lies here, 70. So I just go up to here and I touch the Biot number line and go in this direction. At where it intersects the y-axis, that is the value of t minus t infinity by t naught minus t infinity. in this expression, we know the atmospheric temperature, we know the initial temperature. So just the unknown is T. If you just equate this value to the oncoming value, then you will get the temperature at a given time, and our goal is achieved. Okay. And by the way, I have given the ranges of Biot number and Fourier number, but I forgot to mention the ranges of this temperature distribution also. So if the temperature is given by at a particular time, so it can't be over than the initial temperature. It must be less than the initial temperature, or at time equals zero, it is very equal to the initial temperature. So the ratio always becomes less than or equals 1. Why? Because the upper term is at T equals 0, the upper term is similar to the denominator term. So it will be cancelled and will give a value of 1. At any time, 1, 2, 3 seconds, the temperature here is decreasing. So definitely the numerator value is less than the denominator. So the value of T minus T infinity by T naught minus T infinity must start from 0.0001 to 1. The highest value is 1, highest possible value. Okay. So it must start from 0.00 or 0.01. You can take anything you want based on your accuracy level. So I'm just taking 0.001 to the maximum value of 1. And the Fourier number starts from 0 to 700. 700 is the practically more viable condition. Okay. That is not, you don't particular with the 700 number. It is the practical cases. Most practical cases end with 700 only. There is no extra case than 700. Okay. Let me show you the real graph of this situation. I just give you the information. The real graph will look like this. Okay. Exactly what I said. You can see here. Let me change my pen color so that it will be visible for you. Here the values of the distribution starts from 0.001 and it must end at 1. Is it correct? Yes, absolutely, we achieved one thing. And next, the Fourier number will start from 0. Why? Because at time 0, the Fourier number is alpha T by LC square. At time 0, the Fourier number will become 0. So the Fourier number will start from 0 and ends at some certain value. So here I am just taking the random value of 7. Okay, or most practical cases are limited to 700. Okay, and the Biot number, we know that we have to take the inverse of Biot number. Okay, here the inverse values come from this direction. I don't know how to plot the graph. Okay, here I just given the random information. I'm just plotting the graph from Biot number 1 by 0.1 to 1 by 100, but it is my assumption. I am not a scientist, and of course I'm not a mathematician also. So I have just taken the random values. I have not spent years and years of my research on the Heisler chart development. So the Heisler has taken so much time to develop the lines by inverse Biot number lines so that it exactly matches with the temperature distribution. So he is a mathematician, so he can solve our problem. So where to draw the Biot number, then it will exactly give the accurate result, T minus T infinity divided by T naught minus T infinity, and that is e power minus Biot number Fourier number. So at exactly the Biot number line intersected with the Fourier number line, so that the exponential relation will also satisfied, and it will give an exact value of T minus T infinity by T naught minus T infinity. Okay. So that is very much complicated system. We don't want to try that also. Okay. Just read as it is. So save your time here. So the Biot number lines are given from this direction, like 100, 90, 70 up to 0. Okay. Up to now, there is no problem on Heisler chart. Okay. If the problem comes, definitely in the online exam, he will give this chart also. Not these much values. They give just whatever the required values. If you don't know how to read the Heisler chart, then you will definitely lose your marks. Okay. It is my sincere suggestion. Before going to the exam, just see the Heisler chart one time. Okay. You learn it from the basics to the extreme. You learn why these values are from 0 to 700, why these values are from 0 to 1, and why the Biot number values are like this only, and why we have to use this chart. Okay, you learn each and everything. You just see the chart and you can remember each and everything in fraction of seconds. Okay. Okay, you told me the Biot number lies less than 0.1. It is a lumped parameter, lumped analysis. Okay. if the Biot number is greater than 0.1 and less than 100, then we have to use Heisler chart. If Biot number greater than 100, what to do? There is a specific method called error function. Okay, we never require this thing. Why? Because we can't solve the error functions with our calculator, with our given online calculator in the GATE exam. Okay, so no require, not required for the GATE exam. Okay, in the first case, the internal conductive resistance is very, very much less than the external convective resistance. In the second case, the internal conductive resistance is similar to the is having similar significance to the external convective resistance. In here, definitely the internal conductive resistance is very, very much greater than the external convective resistance. Okay, so these are the three cases that we have in a unsteady state conduction. Well, in the next lecture, I will teach you about the time response of a system. Okay, that is also generated from the above concepts. Okay, you just come to know what is the importance of time response of a system. Okay, thank you for watching.